Hello friends and family, welcome back to Code Academy channel. This is just a quick review on how to install HTML and CSS themes in Blazor server or Blazor WebAssembly application. The first thing that you must do here is you have to download the themes first. Go to bootstrapmade.com to get the themes for free. They have paid themes over there. You can also grab a copy for free. So I have a zip file, and that is a zip file here. So this is a zip file. You see, you have a website themes, and this is a zip file. So these files, you see, we have the index. These are the pages, and you have the asset, and we have the vendor, the CSS, and the JS, and everything here. So if I run this, this is what I have. So the default one is this. Okay. Now, with this, know this is made up of Bootstrap, and it is CSS and HTML. But you know, when you try to install themes into Blazor, when you use UI components, such as when you're using same facing components, Ryzen, and other Blazor X components, you may not be able to get these themes as you see here. That is why you need to install this. But you know, one thing is you can decide to create it your own, but if you don't know how to design, things like this, then it becomes very difficult for you to make your website or web app attractive. So that is why you need to go in for this already made themes. Now these themes are made up of HTML and CSS, but it is possible that you can include it into your Blazor application, and that is a review of what I'm going to do. I've done a video that is step by step of doing it, and it is there. So check the description, there's a link over there, watch that. This is just for those who actually know who have done it before or who know a little about Blazor. They can just get it quick and we move on. So let's see what we can do here. Now this is the theme that I have installed. So first of all, you know, we have to open the index. So this is the index page. Now this index page comprises of the CSS and also comprises of the script file. Now you know, in order to script, you have to link this inside our page. So we copy the script and the CSS, and now we go to, this is a Blazor server app, so we go to our host, we paste the that is a script, and I will paste the CSS here. That's all. When we are done, go to main layout. Now you can see I've cleared all the sections here, and I left only the main, whereby I created two components, that's a header component and a footer component. Now after creating it, I went here and have to just copy the footer. Now you can see this page, you can just see we have, there's a footer, we have a there's a footer start from here, we have the main section, so just grab the footer and I'll paste it inside the footer component. Do the same thing to the head and I'll paste the head component. So when you check the footer, there's a footer component, and if you check the head, there's a header component. Okay, so when you have this, then you go to, there is an Astra home, that is the rest. So this is the main component, that what you can see over here. Now when you are done, what you have to do here is you go to the main layout and I'll link them here. So header must be on top and a footer must be after the body component, okay, or the body here holder. So this is a very simple thing that you have to do, or you can do. It's very simple. Now when you're done and you run the application, you're going to see this here. You can start to change the size or change the background color of this. Go to the header component and you can apply Bootstrap classes to it. So header component, and you can see here, I just applied BG info. You can make it BG danger, BG success. You can change the button colors, and a lot of things that can be changed here. Okay. Also, the features that you see, you can decide to take some of the features out. So Control K and C like this. I don't want the login anymore, so I can just run this. I could say I'm hiding that. I can just remove it from it, and you're gonna have what you want. So this is a template that you see, and here you need to edit it to suit what you want. The reason why we set this is, listen, the reason why now we decide to create a header and a footer here is, see, if I click and decide to set something here, the footer is going to maintain and the header is going to maintain, but the body is going to go out. You can see the body is not there, header it is there, footer it is there. So all the pages that are going to create are going to be found within here as a body tag. So it's going to hold this place, going to hold the pages that are going to be clicking or displaying to the user. Okay, So this footer and this header, we are making it as a static, and it's going to be there till the whole page. Yeah, this is a very simple thing to do. Actually, the source code of this, I'm not going to leave it to the GitHub description link, because you know what, it is a theme that I downloaded. And if you want to download the same theme, then go to bootstrapme.com, and that is over here. Grab a source, that's a theme for free. It is there, you can grab it for free, and I'll follow the procedure, and you're good to go. Very interesting as well. Okay, so that is a bootstrapme.com. So go there and get the free themes, paid one over there, get any one that you want, and now implement it as you've done here. All right, so that is it for this video. Now you can see from here, as soon as I load this, let's see what happens. So when you get this, and as soon as you load it, you have this beautiful theme made by Bootstrap. You can see from here, Bootstrap, bootstrapmadethemes.com. Go there and get the themes. As for me, you know, I'm not good at the front end, so I don't have time. I can't even design a whole lot of this here like that. But if you know if you can do this, then yes, you can start. But you know, not to waste time, it is already. Why don't you take this opportunity, grab it, and make it your own? That's all. You're good to go. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Yeah, so you made it. Now you have a Bootstrap application, a web app with nice interface as a Blazor application. Thank you, and make sure you subscribe to this channel as well, and catch you up in the next video.